the trash in the universe needs taking out, he's there. When the men from Mercury invade, he's there. He's sharper than a shooting star and quicker than a quasar. He is Dick Dale, interstellar investigator. This is Dick Dale's Intergalactic Tale. Fighting for what's right on the final frontier. This week's episode, Attack of the Killer Gorilla.
Hey.
Hi.
You're in my place?
What?
This is kind of my area.
but it's a public park. Yeah, sure, I can go.
It's not every day a hot dame like that walks into your office. Her lips say one thing, but her eyes say another. I've seen tough girls like that before, and I can tell when something's on their mind. I decided to stick around.
What's a girl like you doing in a dump like this?
Excuse me?
Exactly.
So, you like WKD?
Yeah, I like to pee. Yeah, it's nice, it's warm.
What?
I like to pee.
I said, do you like WKD?
Oh.
Did you hear that?
You ain't heard nothing yet, honey.
No, I'm being serious. There's something out there.
Something out there? You never got over your bedtime stories?
I'm being serious. This case isn't like the other cases.
What?
That thing that killed my sister, it's not a normal man.
Okay, well, we can deal with the non-normal man later.
This isn't a joke! That thing could pounce on us at any second!
Are you sure? Because, you know, I think I can hear the monster. He's walking away.
I know it's there. I can sense it.
Really?
You didn't think this would be that easy, did you? I've seen it myself, and it's not an ordinary monster.
Well, I ain't no ordinary man. This isn't how the story's supposed to go.
With a hero in peril, what will we do next?
The fuck?
He curses and spouts in turmoil, hopelessly at a loss. It's tough to say what's tormenting him more, losing the beast or defect with this most embarrassing failure. His femme fatale can never look him in the eye again.
Come on, I mean, she won't be that mad. It's not...
Her high spirits will plummet, and her nerves will go awry at this catastrophic calamity.
Jeez.
After all, a deadbeat detective is no place in a woman's heart.
Dick! Dick, oh, Dick, I've been looking everywhere for you. Are you all right?
I'm still standing.
Oh, I was so worried about you when you killed Beast. Oh, Dick, I don't know what I'd do without you.
You don't have to worry about me, honey.
How did you kill it?
Huh?
The beast, oh, you must have looked so brave and so heroic and... Oh, Dick, I knew you'd kill it. I knew it.
Yes, I
must admit, when I first met you, I thought you were a bit of a fuddy-duddy, what with all that talk of pee at the party.
Well, actually, that...
But now you've done this, oh, Dick, now I know what kind of man you really are. Did I just see what I think I saw?
Honey, I can explain.
You dirty, rotten liar! You said you'd gotten rid of that thing.
But I just wanted to be with you.
You know what the worst thing is about you, Dick? It's not the failure of the case. It's not you lying to me. You may smoke a pipe and wear the hat, but underneath it all, you're just a little boy playing detective. And I don't date little boys. Wake up. You get really weird sometimes.
Weird is good, you know? You wouldn't want me to be boring, would you?
Weird is weird, Rich.
Maybe I'm the normal one and everyone else is the weird one.
You're not funny.
Look, can't we just go home, watch TV or something? I'm getting sick of you getting stuck in your own head all the time. We never do anything together anymore. And you drag me all the way out here into the woods to what? To daydream?
No. I thought going to the woods would be like a nice change of scenery. I thought it would be romantic.
Stop acting like you're in a movie, Rich.
You're right. I should stop acting. I don't think this is gonna work.